I'm Britney Spears, and you're watching 1515.
This week from Hawaii, Britney Spears hits the beach to talk about love, fame, and body piercing, with Destiny's Child tagging along too. Snoop Dogg makes his movie star bones in a new feature film, and House of Pain vet Danny Boy takes hip-hop techno with the ex-supermodels.
Welcome to 1515. Hi, I'm Chris Connolly, and we are in Honolulu, Hawaii. We're Britney Spears. How are you?
I'm good. How are you?
I'm not too bad. Now, you're about to do a concert here, aren't you? Got a fabulous stage set up.
So excited.
You ever played in Hawaii before?
No, I haven't. So it's here on the beach, so I can't wait.
It's not bad. Now, you've already gotten to enjoy yourself here. You got to lay out for a while. Did you get a little sun?
Yesterday, I had a day off, and I got to experience that. I laid out all day, had a massage. It was really nice.
So it's kind of a restful thing, but you'll be performing your little butt off there, won't you, moments from now?
Oh, yeah.
All right, then. Well, it sounds like a lot of fun. Britney and I had a chance to sit down not long ago and talk about the new record and all the changes in her life. Let's go to it right now. You have fun up there.
I will.
I did it again. I played with your heart. Got lost in the game. Oh, baby, baby, you think I'm in love. From above, I'm not that innocent.
Yes, she's done it again, and there's no oops about it. The same popified new Jill swing, the same irresistibly sly vocals, another boldly kinetic video. But as an 18-year-old Britney Spears prepares to drop a second album, there's a lot that's new, starting with her belly button.
I do notice the little pierced tummy there.
It only lasts for 2 seconds, but those 2 seconds, I was like you can't hardly talk. I thought I was going to faint. It was really bad, but I don't regret it now. I like it.
That sense of daring finds expression on Oops, I Did It Again, with a female empowerment cover of the Rolling Stones' Satisfaction.
You can tell me who to be, babe.
What is that identity? Her new record's lyrics offer a tougher, more self-reliant Britney than the first record's yearning girl.
My loneliness is killing me. Loneliness ain't killing me no more.
I'm really excited about this record, just that I've had a lot more involvement with it, and it's just really special to me. I mean, every song I can almost totally relate to, and I think it's definitely more mature.
Offstage, though, that maturity seems very much a work in progress, as Britney still welcomes her parents' guidance.
You'll be registering a vote?
Probably so. I'll just probably vote whoever my mom or my dad votes for, because I'm so busy all the time. I should actually probably pay more attention to what goes on television.
What has mom told you never to do? Never get a tattoo, anything else?
Probably that. Just never get a tattoo. And never do drugs. Other than that, you know. I could do anything else.
Britney has always turned to her mother, Lynn Spears, for personal and career support. Nearly a decade ago, Mom drove Britney and two of her friends 480 miles from Kentwood, Louisiana to Atlanta, Georgia, to an open audition for the Mickey Mouse Club.
I was like 8 years old, and there was like 2,000 kids there, and we all went in this room, and we sang for this Matt Casella. He was the guy that was the casting director.
She was so outgoing, and she was also very shy and a little scared, you know. But once it came time to perform, it was like the switch was on.
He narrowed it down to like 6 kids. And we were so excited.
I don't know what her mom or where her mom had brought her prior to those auditions, but she had so much experience for a 9-year-old.
But we didn't get it, so we were sad.
Matt hooked Britney up with an agent in New York, where the then 10-year-old and her pregnant mom relocated for a time. She eventually landed a slot on the Mickey Mouse Club in Orlando. But when the show was canceled, it was back to Louisiana and high school life.
Yeah, but I was just at home doing nothing, and I was just like so bored.
She dreamed of a recording career. Then she got the call, come to New York and audition for a host of music company executives. It would be the most nerve-wracking experience of her life.
I was so nervous because I'm used to performing in front of big crowds and stuff. And I was walking in here and there was like 4 executive people just staring there looking at you. I was like, oh lordy, what am I gonna do? So then I sang for all of them, and then like a week later, Jive Records called me up and they signed me. It was like the happiest moment of my life. It's like, I'm gonna make my own album.
Her dreams became reality, but so did some tabloid nightmares, including speculation about her personal life and her physical appearance.
I mean, at first it was hard for me to deal with, but now I've gotten totally used to it. But my mom still, yeah, she's very sensitive. I mean, I'm her baby, you know what I mean? So if anyone's saying anything negative about me, she's like, I want to call that person up and talk to that person. I'm like, Mom, it's okay, don't worry about it. It's okay, you know? She's just like that.
And Mom has always been protective, ever since she wrote a prescient poem about Britney when the future superstar was just 4 years old.
She's the great gift, a gift of spring. You just enjoy watching. She will dance and sing. Cruel world, turn away. Spare my little star. Let her wit and charming beauty go very far.
Now Britney seeks out her mom whenever she feels overwhelmed by the isolation of her celebrity.
Sometimes when you're surrounded by so many people, you can still be so lonely. You know what I mean? Just coming at night and just like, Mom, I miss you. I want to be with you right now.
Britney's on a grueling schedule to promote her new record and perform live this summer. But after more than a year and a half in the spotlight, she remains unaffected, without attitude, and eager for the one happiness that, she says, has thus far eluded her.
Are you in love now?
No.
Do you wish you were? Is that the thing that's missing now, or?
Yeah, I would like to have a boyfriend. I mean, it's a nice feeling to be loved. Who doesn't want to be loved, you know what I mean? But it's probably kind of good that I'm not, because I don't want to have to miss someone and just really kind of busy, you know? But yeah, that would be cool.
All right, and already the crowd is gathered here. Come on, crowd. Already the crowd is gathered here to catch Britney's free concert here on the shores in Hawaii. How do you guys feel? You excited to see Britney?
Yeah! Woo!
How long have you been a Britney fan? A long time?
Oh. Forever.
Forever. Forever and a day. That's what it's going to look like here. Saturday what? Paul I. Moore coming on 1515, including a look inside the world of Snoop Dogg. Keep it here.
Jimmy Bones is the biggest thing to hit the big screen since John Travolta in Saturday Night Live. You dig?
Welcome to the future with an all-new 10 spot. Wednesday at 10 p.m., an all-new biorhythm featuring the life of Eminem.
Mother, are you there? I love you. I never meant to hit you over the head with that shovel.
MTV, the new, is now at the 10 spot.
Integra GSR from Acura.
On May 19th, love is never having to say you're sorry you made a sex tape with another girl and accidentally mailed it to your girlfriend.
Oh my God, I have to get to that tape before my girlfriend gets back to her school.
We're all gonna see it sooner or later.
Road trip.
From DreamWorks Pictures comes a story about going too far.
Relax.
And then going even further.
What was that? Did you kill a cheetah?
Yeah. Road trip.
I had sex last night.
With a girl.
Rated R. Whoa. Starts Friday, May 19th.
See performing Cabaret.
I'm Rosie.
I'm Lulu.
And I'm anyone you want me to be.
It's hot.
This show's
Cabaret
very sexy.
Is a hot,
Cabaret is a hot show.
Live theater. Anything can happen.
No predictability.
Well, they asked us to try this
degree invisible solid body heat activator.
Your body temperature goes up, it goes down, it goes up and down,
and degree stuck with me. I loved it.
No white marks, nothing. So they're looking at me and my flawless performance.
We need this.
Degree invisible solid.
Schick und clean und hier.
Is finding the right computer keeping you up? You could get this one. But does it include internet service? Nope. Or you could go with this one. But does it offer 24/7 tech support or enough memory? No. Or you could go with a Gateway Performance PC and get AOL included 24/7 tech support and now a free memory upgrade, all for just $45 a month. That should make you rest easy. Call 1-800-GATEWAY, featuring the Intel Pentium 3 processor.
Delta Bravo, flight at 2, 5 hours.
They get hired by companies like AT&T, GE, training in over 200 real-world jobs. And they get it in the Army. That's right, the Army.
Hey, was thinking about lunchtime, huh? We could get out there, we get ourselves some panda lunch. You want a panda's for lunch, don't you? He has bamboo.
Come to lunch and have some bamboo with me.
Not going anywhere for a while? Grab a Snickers. That ought to hold you.
You trade everything from email to lipstick. But at the Pond's Institute, what's not up for trade is getting rid of blemishes without irritating skin. Our overnight blemish reducers with botanical extracts help reduce blemishes without irritation. Overnight blemish reducers, the science of you.
Louis D. Brown.
She pulls it and puts it out. Yeah, hold it up for you.
He never saw his little sister grow up. Had enough? Call 1-900-454-MOMS and join Handgun Control in supporting the Million Mom March across America.
Welcome back to Hawaii, where the drinks are cold, the people are warm, and everything ends in an I. Is there any person in show business who's busier these days than Snoop Dogg? Consider, he just shot a video with Dr. Dre. He's got that Dre Eminem Cube Tour ready to drop on the 15th of June in San Diego. That'll go for a month or so. Then he's got a record of his own for No Limit. He executive produced that East Side is record. Plus, he's making a movie in Vancouver called Bones, directed by Ernest Dickerson. Let's go to Vancouver and have a look, shall we?
Hello.
Snoop Dogg has been up on the big screen before, of course, playing everything from himself in rap documentaries to such characters as this well-toasted pothead.
What's up, dog? Scoot off. Let me get in here, man. How you doing?
In Bones, though, for the first time, Snoop has the lead role in a feature that was written to order expressly for him.
We was always saying that I wanted to be in a movie where it would be a movie based around me as the lead character, but it would be something that would be strong enough to make the whole world want to see it. I've not proven myself in the movie world, but they allowed me the opportunity to handle a whole movie. And I promise I won't let them down. Don't you worry about nothing, baby. These hands of mine are going to be stroking your neck tonight.
Jimmy, please. No, come on. Please.
Hush, baby.
In this Shaft meets Tales from the Crypt thriller, Snoop plays Jimmy Bones, a 70s vigilante who comes back to his old neighborhood 20 years later, seeking revenge for his own murder.
Jimmy Bones is the biggest thing to hit the big screen since John Travolta in Saturday Night Live, you dig? It's a whole phenomenon behind this here. His dress, his hair, his attitude, his car, his woman. Nah, baby, all wrong. It's got to start at the belly button, and it's got to be in the enemy.
In a casting coup of sorts, Snoop's love interest in the film is played by the original Foxy Brown, blaxploitation icon Pam Grier.
You're going for the extreme kiss now. Ooh, lip lock.
I'm a big fan of Pam Grier, so if you see me on the set, like, blushing or, you know, kissing her when I ain't supposed to be or having too much fun, it's because I'm living my dream out, you know what I'm saying? And she understands that, and she's a beautiful woman and a friend and, you know, somebody that I can, you know, cry on her shoulders if I need to, or just explain some real stuff to her, so.
Having done 70s style and horror shtick before in music videos, Snoop says he had no trouble slipping into character as Jimmy Bones.
It's not a costume, baby, it's me, you know? When I take it off, it's a costume. You dig? When I got it on, it's me. I'm not tired for the movie, I'm tired because I just did Dr. Dre video all night last night.
With the D-O-double-G. In addition to flying back to L.A. for video shoots during breaks in the Bone shooting, Snoop's also been busy rehearsing for his big summer tour with Dr. Dre, Ice Cube, and Eminem, not to mention polishing off his final album for Master P by July 4th, and executive producing the Eastsiders for his own label.
Sounds like Mama needs a brand new bag.
Jimmy, come on, let me see your hands.
Whether or not Bones will propel him to the cinematic heights already inhabited by such rappers as Will Smith and Ice Cube remains to be seen, but Snoop says he is ready for his close-up.
I want to do this when I finish with rapping. I want to go full speed on this acting thing, you know. Because it's more behind the scenes. The rapping thing, you're on the front line all the time. You know what I mean? This is behind the scenes. Then when it come out, then you hot. Rapping thing is all year round. It's like a full season. We don't never get a vacation.
Snoop in Canada, and I am here in Hawaii with Destiny's Child, and if I just can talk long enough, I could just stand here all day. Anyway, you guys are actually going to perform with Britney, aren't you, Kelly?
Yes, we are very excited about performing with Britney. We actually ran into her in Cologne, Germany.
How about that?
And we talked about it. She was like, I can't wait till you guys come down. We were like, we can't wait to come down. We're in beautiful Hawaii. What better place to be? We're just very thankful.
Now, you guys are working here, but do you get to play a little bit Beyonce? Do you get to have a little fun in Hawaii?
Well, we're actually going into the studio after the performance, but we can't wait. We're going to be getting up at like 6 o'clock in the morning, going to see Hawaii and see what it has to offer. We already see these beautiful fans and the beautiful water. And
look, there we go. A little love for Destiny's Child. Don't go down the baby. Shouldn't be beautiful thing. Lots more to come on 1550, including whatever became of that third guy from House of Pain. Keep it here.
I didn't know how that would work. It's kind of like, you know, when they mix the peanut butter with the chocolate and then you got...